Today we have an important event in the life of the temple that for the first time His Excellency Mr. Ashok Sajjanhar, Ambassador of India in Sweden and Latvia, is visiting the temple for the official opening and inauguration of the main temple entrance of our prayer temple room and of the second hall of vegetarian restaurant. We are very thankful for the fact that you agreed to come here. You are welcome here. And we will start the program with the opening of the temple.
Thank you very much. Thank you. Deeply appreciate.
Thank you. Great days that we have a nice place where we can receive new people who come here, receive guests. So please come in.
I'm very happy to be here. Thank you very much. Thank you.
Purusha Jaya Prabhupada, Jaya Prabhupada, Jaya Prabhupada, Jaya Prabhupada,
Bye.
First of all, to say what a great pleasure and what a great joy, and indeed what a great privilege it is for me to be here on this very important occasion, on this very special occasion. And I would of course like to take this opportunity to thank you and congratulate you and congratulate all the devotees and everyone who is present here on this very important and special occasion. My contact and connection with the Sri Krishna movement all over the world has been there for many, many years, many, many decades I can say. And I must confess that whenever I have visited an ISKCON temple, whether it is in different parts of India, whether it is in Bangalore or Pune or Mumbai or Delhi or anywhere else in the world, whether it is Moscow or Washington or Belgium or Netherlands, I have always been very deeply touched and impressed and in fact overwhelmed by the energy, by the enthusiasm, by the devotion, by the commitment of the people, and their single-minded pursuit
of promotion of brotherhood and good relations amongst the people. I think the old ancient Hindu scriptures speak of the whole world as being a family. Vasudhaiva Kutumbakam, the whole world is a family. And it is indeed the Sri Krishna movement and under ISKCON and the teachings of Swami Prabhupada who have really reached out and brought the whole world in its fold, in its embrace, and treated them as one family. So I'm really very happy to be here. Let me congratulate you, all of you, on this very important special occasion. And as you have mentioned, it will be our endeavor, my personal endeavor and that of my colleagues in the embassy, to stay in touch with all of you and to see what we can do together, how we can work together to further promote and propagate the teachings of Bhagavad Gita, and which are so important. They were extremely important when they were pronounced many millennia ago, and their relevance and importance has increased manifold today. So I welcome this opportunity to work together with you to promote and propagate the teachings of Bhagavad Gita, that we need to continue to do our work, we need to continue on our path of non-violence. Thank you very much once again for being here, and I wish all of you good health, happiness and success and peace of mind in whatever you are doing. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. We are very thankful for your kind words. We are just a very tiny part of this mission of spreading Vedic culture, and we will try to live up to things which you told so that we actually manage to do these things. We are learning, we are trying, and we hope that we will be successful with your blessings.